This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Srinivasan. I'm joined by the head of the Nike Foundation, Maria Idle. You've got a project that you've been pushing for quite some time, the Girl Effect. And what's fascinating now is at the Clinton Global Initiative, you're announcing a couple of projects that are focusing on 12-year-old girls. Why is, first of all, what's the project? And two, why is 12 so important?
Well, it was about 7 years ago that the Nike Foundation decided to focus exclusively on adolescent girls for a very simple reason. If you can get to a girl before she's HIV positive, pregnant, and married, you can change the trajectory of poverty and stop it before it starts, because she's uniquely able to break the intergenerational cycle. So everything we do is about that, and the Girl Effect is what we call it, which is when you do that, it doesn't just affect her life, but everybody around her, family, her community, and her nation. So the kinds of things we were doing at CGI this year had some great commitments. Every year we've had commitments from day one. But the first commitment was just, let's focus on girls. Now, at the time, that was a really big deal, because 6-7 years ago, this issue was really a side issue. This wasn't something on the front agenda at all. So the fact that this week, wherever you go, you're seeing girls and women, girls. Mm-hmm. It's a huge shift in the issue. So Toast On is one of the commitments we've made, which is a program that stops harmful traditional practices, engages the community in making that change happen. And what we've done is we've created a breakthrough fund with them. It gets all their donors to work together. Instead of all this inefficiency of like, hey, you got to give us the reports. We have to have special for everyone. Everybody's working together with one organization for their success. So that's just one of the example of kinds of things we've been doing.
And what are some of the statistics today about how many young girls are basically kind of off the track? They're not in school, they're married very young, they're having children very young.
They're pretty dismal, I gotta tell you, Hari. It's very frustrating to see these statistics still persist today. They're the kinds of things when you hear them, you wonder, how can that still be happening today? The number one cause of death for girls in poverty is pregnancy and childbirth.
Wow.
Girls 15 years old are the largest, 15 and under, have the most violence in the world against them. Child brides, there are just, it's just the things that happen to girls too. It's not just the statistics. It's that these are irreversible events. When you're married at 9 or 10 or 11 years old, it's not, there's not like some clever way out of that. You're not going to have another chapter. That's really a dead end to your potential. The same with having children so young. The ability to be a mother, even to be raise healthy children and have the knowledge and skills to be a healthy mother, you aren't equipped for that. So what we're trying to do is get resources to girls so they don't become those statistics, so that we can break that bad cycle that just keeps repeating over and over again, another generation born into poverty.
So what are we talking about? Basically access to healthcare and education?
Well, the main thing everybody thinks of is those two. And of course, we've got to do those well. But then what's important is we've got to link things. People aren't one thing. You aren't education or health. She can't complete school if she's HIV positive or pregnant, right? So we've got to link those things. And then we've got to link them to employment. So if she makes it from primary school to secondary school to some kind of livelihood, then we have to figure out how do we connect it to the really big things that are happening in the world. Women and girls will produce 70% of the food in the world, yet own 1% of the land. So it looks like girls are the farmers of the future. We might want to invest in them like they are, which is start really young, give them the knowledge and skills that they need as we become a woman, instead of waiting till it's too late and then trying to fix the problems afterward.
And one of the things that you're starting to push also is kind of the economic impact, which is kind of interesting because there haven't been any kind of hard data on what is the impact if a girl is no longer a productive member of the economy or if she's pregnant very quickly. What were the kind of more startling findings for you?
Well, one of the things that was very frustrating 7 years ago when we started this is we knew intuitively, common sense tells you, that if the mother of every child who's going to be born in poverty is healthy, well-educated, that's going to result in very positive things. And something tells you, very common sense, that if it doesn't happen, negative things are going to occur. The problem is we didn't have any numbers on that. We didn't really know. So we funded with the World Bank the Girl Dividend, Unleashing the Girl Effect. And what we found is the numbers are staggering, absolutely staggering. So if you are able to delay that first birth, the impact is enormous. If you can do that by 10% in Brazil alone, that results in $353 million added annually to that economy. Take a big country like India, and you're going to see all the way to $767 million added to that economy. Now, run that in the lifetime of a girl in India and you get into the billions. Wow. Now you're talking about $383 billion added to the economy in the lifetime of those girls. So let's put it in context. The full profits, the combined profits of the Fortune 100 companies in 2010 is that same number. All the aid in 2009 is also $383 million. So you're talking about numbers that are so big, right. And we still tend to see it as a side issue, something that we don't see as center stage. And I think what we're trying to see happen here is go from an issue that we think is nice to have mm-hmm. to an issue that moves economies.
So are you getting this traction? Are world leaders seeing this, saying, okay, well, it's not just a feel-good issue, but economically it's very important for me to invest in these girls?
Well, we've gone from being off the agenda
right.
to being on the agenda. Now we have to go from being on the agenda to real resources. Because if you look, it has not yet happened that there are real resources going. You don't see countrywide programs. So for instance, we have a partnership with the Department for International Development in the UK. Now, they work at scale in countries, and we have combined together to produce something called 12 Plus. Now, this is a nationwide program to get girls, as they go into puberty, into the healthcare system. That's never been done. That's the kind of scale of investment that we're looking to see. And we're just starting to see a little bit of that from real champions like DFID and the World Bank today making some new commitments. So hopefully we get that momentum going, but we're not there yet. I don't want anybody to declare victory yet. We got a long way to go.
All right, Maria Idle from the Nike Foundation, thanks so much for stopping by.
Thank you, Hari. Great to talk with you.
This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Srinivasan. Stay with us.